most people, scientists who work at NASA, that's like, I always wanted to work at NASA. And I have to tell you this, I'm at NASA on a bet.
Discovery, I'm at the 90.
Standing by now for burnout and jettison the twin solid rockets. Altitude 67 miles, 350 miles northeast of the Kennedy Space Center.
This is Apollo Control. Distance from Earth 6,649 miles.
And liftoff.
I came to the U.S. when I was 17, and I love to watch Abdul Mojini. And the guy worked at NASA, right? When I used to dream about, like, maybe I can work in NASA one day.
I don't think I have anyone on my team that was like, I'm going to grow up to be A, and then I'm going to do B and C.
Yeah.
Everybody has been like, well, I was interested in this, but then I did this, and then I worked here for a while, and now I kind of want to do this.
Some people went to the military before working at NASA. Some people go to community college first and then go to a four-year school. Some people become parents first.
In college, there was a flyer that says, come work at NASA. And I remember it like it was yesterday, my buddy Dave Beasley. I said, Dave, you fill out the application. He's like, no, you fill it out. I was like, no, you fill it out. He said, I bet you won't fill it out. No, I said, I bet you won't fill it out. So I filled it out. I'm teaching high school mathematics, and there's a call. And it's like, oh, come to the office. NASA's on the phone. And I use a square word. I was like, bull crap.
I grew up in Sausalito, California. I have a PhD in engineering physics, but my route to that final degree destination was sort of maybe slightly circuitous. I played music. I went to music school. I bailed out of music school. I came back to San Francisco Bay Area. I was playing in a few different bands, playing around the Bay Area. Anyway, I had actually started to notice that when I would return home from playing a show at night, the stars were in a different place in the sky. And so I went to the local community college to take an astronomy course to teach me why the stars were moving. And all of a sudden, I was just on fire.
I currently work at NASA JPL. I am the mission lead of the Mars Curiosity rover. It is an SUV-sized nuclear power laser beam eye rover. My job is to troubleshoot anything that happens to the rover. So anything that goes wrong with the rover, it's my problem, it's my team that needs to figure it out. In the morning, the rover wakes up and it says, talk to me. And so we go ahead and then uplink the 9 hours of here's what you're gonna do today. Pretty much like, this is my celebrity, here is your itinerary of the day. And we need to shoot a bunch of images, have those images downlinked, as analyzed and say, well, I think I can drive through there without a problem with the rover and command it. Because the rover is sitting on Mars, it takes approximately 14 minutes or so of the signal to make it to the rover and 14 minutes to come back, which means that by the time you have sent something, 28 minutes have happened, and 28 minutes later, you know you're in trouble. And now you have to react to it very quickly. So I love the rush.
And I got pulled into the Mars Exploration Rover, Spirit and Opportunity, and I led the mechanical engineering of the landing system for that. Even where I've gravitated to at work is the high risk and most exposed you could be part of the job. And I am always somehow courting that edge to prove to myself that I'm not trapped in the fear.
Welcome to the Green Lab Research Facility. This is a hobby turned into a mad profession. I have what some people would call a dream job now. And the reason why I say that is 95% of things we do at NASA are failures, but we learn from them.
And so today I'm an engineer, a project management engineer, doing construction specifically for the B2 test stand, which is behind us here. And we'll go to the moon, to Mars, and asteroids and beyond with that vehicle.
We might be looking at an object of, say, an exploded star. And you can slice and dice that data into a simple two-dimensional image. That tells you part of the story, right? But if you have more data, then you can take it a step further and bring it into a three-dimensional model. Once you have a 3D model in place of an astronomical object, what you do with it, those options are limitless.
So right now I'm a mechanical test operations engineer, and some of my coworkers, they're testing the RS-25 engines, which will one day send astronauts to Mars. I love what I do. I really enjoy testing rocket engines, and haven't had any doubt since I got here that this is where I was supposed to be.
And so when you're applying for something that you're really passionate about, don't prejudge yourself. Don't let doubt rule you, because I've gotten chosen. And so I encourage people to push and put in for things that they're curious about. Go ahead and put the application in. Go ahead and look for that dream and follow that mission.